go. Miles leading the way. We're going to be catching our next flight to Copenhagen. And there'll be anything more from the beginning of the terminal. And we'll start the next trip report. We have to see where our transfer flight is going to be going from. Coolest here in Turkey. 4 degrees it was, huh?
10 in Copenhagen.
10, oh, that's warmer. It's a little bit cold, yeah, I can feel that. International transfers to the left. It's written up there. It's an escalator we can take. It is cold here. Escalator all the way up there. And coming up, look up to the right. Terminals down there, aircraft. Straight ahead and follow the signs as usual to find our transfer flight to Istanbul Airport, the new one. So, passport control transfer straight ahead. Let's go. Put the pedal to the metal. Let's have a look down here first. Also, I remember this. I spent a lot of time here. 8 hours we were here. If you haven't already watched the video for our Istanbul Airport, either it's not up yet, or you can go and have a look at the airport's playlist where we'll upload it. And if it is uploaded already, I will pin a comment down below in the comment section. So, Mato's leading the way as usual. Straight ahead. Transfers up ahead to the right. As you can see, it is a very big airport. We'll be going all the way down there to the right side, following the path. Yeah, the signs are blue, and the other airports, the transfers are often yellow transfer signs. See, there's a TravellerYT, those of you with walking disabilities, and those of us who just want to walk faster. Who's leading the way? Can't really look too west here. Go. Looks like it's got quite a long walk. Short connection international, passport controls. What is a short connection international? What else? Turkish Airlines, Airbus A330 out there. Just keeping up with Mato. Yeah. The first thing we need to do is find a screen that tells us from where, from which gate our flight will be leaving. If it's even on the screen yet, it's still early. What? No, it's not quarter past nine at all. What time is local time now? Five to seven in the morning. It's a very big airport, this one. Just recently opened. A lot of people here at this ungodly hour in the morning. Everybody, probably most people, having a transfer flight somewhere in Europe. This is what it's like to transfer at Istanbul Airport.
Check the board.
Check the board, put it right. One board up there ahead. I don't know, let's go. What time was our flight? Huh?
Copenhagen, there it is.
What time?
Check-in for coming 7:30.
7:30?
Yeah.
What time did you say the flight was?
9:30.
It's 9:30. I thought it was 11:30 or something like that.
9:30 Copenhagen is at AC6693.
Gate info at 7:30, so in over 1 hour's time. Not quite sure if you noticed it or not. I just changed cameras back to our normal 4K camera, camcorder. The video on this the display is a little bit bigger, so I can actually see where what I'm filming. But as you know, we are. Let's just have a look at the aircraft there on my left. Another looks like a Boeing 777. I'm not quite sure. I can't really see, probably from here. We are transferring here at Istanbul Airport now for our Copenhagen flight, which is not on the board yet, but all transfers must go in this direction. It's rather early in the morning, quite a lot of people despite that, a lot of planes coming in, see a lot landing. It's very rainy here, and 4 degrees, quite a difference from the over 30 degrees we've just had in Kuala Lumpur in Malaysia. No, it's nice with a little bit of coolness. Let's take the TravellerYT so we don't get knocked over by this vehicle. So the stripes, the green stripes on the path, that is the road of the shuttle vehicles. There are plenty of shuttle vehicles. It is a big airport. If you have walking disabilities, you are going to want to get a transport service to take you from gate to gate if you're at this airport. Up ahead, toilets, duty-free, passport-controlled transfers. Still straight ahead. Let me follow Maro along. Do I have to say, put the speed on? It's quite a long walk. Let me turn. Ah, there we go. It starts to look like something over there on the right. It's the upstairs part of the airport. We also filmed that in our Istanbul Airport video. Proper tour of this very new airport here in Turkey. I believe Turkey wants to become a, well, at least Turkish Airlines wants to become an international hub, with the same comparison as Doha Airport, Dubai Airport in the Middle East. Still Christmas decorations. Yeah, the party lasts a little bit longer down here. Still straight ahead, quite a hustle and bustle, even though it's early in the morning, as I mentioned before. Lots going on down there. Are you speeding along there, Maro? No aircraft over on the lifts and the runways. How could Maro put a speed on now? Let's go. Still straight ahead, and always just follow the signs in the airport. And you can't go wrong. Nothing to be afraid of. People often ask us how we do it. How anybody else does it, don't be intimidated by it, just follow the paths. Airports are used to having millions of passengers through every year, so they have got some experience with directing us in the right direction. And in this case, we have to go to the right, where there's passport control and transfers. So Maro's really got his speed on there, so let me try and keep up a little bit here. Going down another escalator, I can see. Good idea would be to have some good walking shoes with. I'm going to trot so I can keep up with Maro there. And she is in. Looks like still straight ahead. Up there. It's a very long walk here. It's a long walk, isn't it, Maro? So we just walk rather than take the TravellerYTs. And onward we go. Follow the signs, as you can see the blue signs over there on the right. I just feel like to stretch my legs now rather than ride a TravellerYT after 10 hours in an aircraft. Good to get some circulation going in the legs. onward we go. Another shuttle service coming over there on the right. As you can see, a lot of people taking advantage of that service. Always contact your airline or the airport to organize those kind of things. I'm not quite sure, I've never tried doing that myself. And on we go. Look at all these automated vehicles. That's an automated wheelchair standing on there. As we continue on, it's like an endless walk in this terminal. I can actually feel it because I got a very heavy bag on my back, very heavy camera bag. ATM coming up on the right, money exchange at least. So if you want to buy something at the airport, I'm sure you can use your credit card also. Maro! Just watch out for these vehicles everywhere. There's a passport control on my right over there. Can't film that. What do you see? Let's take the TravellerYT, but it's quite a long walk.
Well, are you tired of it?
Yeah? Well, I'm following you, but you're going very slow. Yeah. Let's put more speed on. Let's see. We've been filming for 6 minutes since I changed camera. So it really is a long walk. Can't be in any doubt about that. There's some sitting areas here on the left. Very big windows at this airport. And plenty of information signs, so you can always keep an eye on what time your flight is leaving and from what gate. As we say, we are taking a Copenhagen flight, which is about 3 hours as far as I remember, and then we'll be back home again. But I must say, this is an incredible job they've done with this airport. It is huge, and it seems to be very effective also. Easy to find your way around. So, up ahead, domestic transfers, international transfers to the right, and transfer desk straight ahead. So I suppose we have to pass through security over here. Can that be right? So we're heading right down to the other end. There are international transfers. There's a big queue there. I suppose we have to pass through security before we can do anything. It's a hell of a queue, one must say. Hopefully it goes quickly. Look at that queue there. Obviously I can't film this, so I'll turn the camera off in just a moment. And we'll see you on the other side. Look at that queue. Lovely queue to wait in at this hour of the morning. And there we go, we just passed through security. Didn't take as long as it looked. It took a little bit long, but not that bad. So if you have a short connection, then you better get to the security area quickly so that you don't get stuck in the queue. And now we're just following the signs again. All gates upstairs. Up we go. Short little escalator. And another escalator. And then we're coming up to the departures area. 7:30 we should have our gate information. Time now is 25 past 7, so not long to go now. Big board coming as we arrive up here in the departures hall. That big board up here doesn't have that many departures on it, so we're going down to one of the smaller information boards that have a lot more gates registered at a time, so we can see what time we're going to be flying. Very big airport, as I've just mentioned a few times. Sorry, I won't sell it anymore. But the Christmas decorations are all still here. It's the 8th of January today, so hopefully they'll start to get the Christmas decorations down soon also. New Year has already passed also. We're heading straight over there in the middle. And you can see the boat just ahead of us now. Now the idea is also to sort of be in a central area so that when we find out where our gate is, we're not at the wrong end of the airport. So try to stay in the middle of everything until we know where we are actually going to. Gates A, B, C, D are all straight ahead of me now. And here comes the board. See if our gate is up yet.
Not there yet.
Hey, no,
it's
B12R.
Is it
B12A?
Yeah.
Let's see. Copenhagen gate. Flight is at 9:30. There it is there. B12A.
Yeah.
So B is straight ahead.
I think that's the same as when we came.
I believe that is when we came. Well, let's go to B. Okay, I'm following you. So, now we know our gate. Gate is B12A, and it's quite a walk from here as far as I remember. It was the same gate we arrived at when we flew from Copenhagen here. A lot of goodies going on over there, people having breakfast, having some nice snacks. We found it to be a little bit pricey when we were here last, compared to other airports like Frankfurt Airport. Straight ahead we go. Marta's got her speed on, maybe a little bit more speeder. And we're going to be going downstairs at the end of the hall here. Our flight leaves at 9:30, so that's in about 2 hours' time. So I'm not quite sure what we're going to be doing. The thing about this airport is, there's free Wi-Fi for everybody, but you have to give your passport number. We're not the kind of people who want to give our passport number freely to anybody. Don't actually understand why we have to give our passport number, but for that reason we won't be using the free Wi-Fi at this airport. Many other airports you can just log on without anything, you just come onto the Wi-Fi immediately. So I don't think it's a very good service either. Wi-Fi should be available to all passengers without having to give any personal details as such. On we go. Following Maro along, someone just jumped here in front of me. Maro, where are you? There you are. And where? B, straight ahead. Straight ahead. Pastries and buns, etc. Here and there. Plenty of shopping opportunities. Shops don't seem to be very busy, but it is very early in the morning still. I'm sure they sell plenty. We're now going to make our way downstairs and take the lift down or an escalator. I think the fastest way is to take the escalator down. You agree, Maro? I'm not going to wait for the lift, though. Off we go, and down we go. I'll turn the camera off here and turn it on when we get down again. And we're going to take the normal steps down, a little bit quicker than waiting for everybody there. I was in a hurry to get down there. Which gate is what? Maro, I forgot which gate it was. B what? 12? Ah, then it's to the right. This way. This right. This right. Yeah, that right. Let's go. Yeah. Straight ahead. Put the speed on. Let's go. The reason I'm telling Maro to put a speed on is because we want to make this transfer video as short as possible, but at the same time show you the full walking distance. So Maro is leading the way. B2 to B18, I can see ahead. B1 to 18. And I said we are B12. Plenty of travelators, but you will be needing assistance if you have difficulty walking, because there are some really big distances here at this airport. As you can see from this transfer walk. already. Here are some of the gates, starting B1 already, to my left. I'm struggling to keep up with Maro. She did get a good speed on now, which is a good thing. Air is a little bit cool here, so make sure you bring a jersey, no matter what time of the year it is, because there is air conditioning on, and that applies to all Asian airports also, or any other place, because you can catch cold very easily from these cold conditions onto a hot plane sometimes. It really does suck the energy out of you, for want of a better word. Look at the ceiling, it's quite impressive in this airport. Hopefully we jump on the Maro. I think we must jump on the TravellerYT next, it goes a bit faster. It's just my excuse because I don't want to walk too far. I'm getting a little bit out of breath here. So onto the TravellerYT we go, all the way down to B12. See where that takes us, or how quickly we get there. As we pass through these guys over here. Thank you. And on we go. It really is a long walk. But lots of space. And on we go. B6, B7, B6 to the right, B5 to the left, and onward we go. If you're in a hurry for a flight, you better put your pedal to the metal, because there can be some really long walking distances here. Next B7, B8, B18, straight ahead. Distance, isn't it? I can't quite see on the display how many minutes we are now. I can say that most of these gate areas, they look the same, whether you're in B, C or D, it's the same layout. B10, B16 to 18, B12 to B15 to the left, and the exchange, my next exchange, as we approach our gates, take that TravellerYT down again. Those of you who need a prayer room, there are prayer rooms here, my next exchange, Sun Terrace upstairs, to the right, Maro, that's one way, there you go, and on we go. B12 to B15. Oh, it wasn't here that we got off, was it? Right down in the end, they've put us on the opposite end. So if your blood circulation is not running in your legs after a long haul flight, I sure as hell are after this walk. Totally warmed up, and I'm not complaining, I must say. It's very nice to stretch the legs in this way. B12, B15, straight ahead, B13, 14, right down there at the end, I can see. On we go. Really is some walking, a lot of nice sitting areas over there. Soft sitting areas also, as you can see. B12 up ahead to the left. Very wet, see the runway out there here, next to these seats. Very wet, rainy day in Istanbul. We are up in gates B13 and 14 now. A lot of people here. I don't know where that flight's going to. Pristina. And there's ours, or Pristina. And there's our gate. Gate B12. So there you go, gate B12, our gate, which we'll be leaving at
When?
9:30.
At 9:30, that's how long the transport walk is.
2 hours.
If you enjoyed the video, if it helped you, please leave us a like down below. If you want to see more videos like this, other airports, trip reports or travel videos, don't forget to subscribe. Thanks for watching. We'll see you on the next video. Bye-bye from me.
From me too.
Bye-bye.